Hi everyone. So today we will be starting a new series on pet parenting. Okay, especially for dogs and cats, vaccination, bathing, grooming, and feeding schedule. Different aspects I will cover. This video is specifically for veterinary students, those who will be attending clinics in near future. Also, the pet parents who will become parents, pet parents for first time. So they should watch this video. And this is basically awareness video, okay, for students. This is a knowledge video. Now vaccination in dogs and cats. First of all, vaccine is basically divided into two types: the core vaccine and the non-core vaccine. Okay, core vaccine is basically the vaccines which you cannot avoid. Okay, you have to give the core vaccines. And the non-core vaccine, depending on the area where you are residing, if the disease is prevalent in that area, then you can give these vaccines. That is why this is non-core vaccine, these are core vaccine. So which vaccines are coming under core vaccine? Most important, you know, rabies vaccine. Next, canine distemper virus. This causes distemper disease. Okay, the canine parvovirus. The parvovirus causes a condition known as hemorrhagic gastroenteritis. Okay, the animal will have a bloody stool and vomition. Next is canine adenovirus type 1. This one causes the hepatitis. Canine hepatitis. Then the canine adenovirus type 2, this causes kennel cough. This kennel cough is more prevalent in countries where the temperate region, mostly the cold climate, this disease is more prevalent. In a hotter climate, you may not find kennel cough. So in some of the vaccines, you may not find the canine adenovirus type 2. Okay. Next, the non-core vaccine, the canine parainfluenza virus causes parainfluenza. Okay, Bordetella, bronchoseptica, Lyme disease, leptospira, then corona, influenza. These are basically non-core vaccines. Okay, depending on your area, you can give these vaccines according to the prevalence of disease. In India, we mostly give corona vaccine, the leptospira vaccine, and the parainfluenza vaccine. Okay, so these three we basically give in India. Also, you can in some part they give Bordetella bronchoseptica. Okay. Now, the coming to the age, from which age we should start the vaccination. For rabies, the primary age is 12 weeks or 3 months. You see, 12 weeks is not equal to 3 months. Okay, in month, in week it is 7 days. So 12 is 84 days, but 3 months is 90 days. But it is okay if you are giving in slightly 3 to 4 day difference. So in India, we usually prefer month wise. Okay, it is easy to remember as a month, whether 3 month, 1.5, dead mahina ya 3 mahina. Aisa kare hafte mein thoda problem hota hai. There is a problem in telling the owner in weeks, but if you are following the weeks, then it is also fine and it's well and good. Okay, so primary is 12 weeks. You see, rabies, in rabies vaccine, in some articles we may find after the primary vaccination, booster is given after 1 year, and each 3 year you will give the rabies vaccine. But in some articles also you will find annual vaccination, only single shot of annual vaccination. I have seen many veterinarians and many medicine shops, they are giving the rabies vaccine in 2 to 3 doses in 3 month interval or 6 month interval. This is not necessary absolutely. So you can give a single dose of rabies vaccine. Modern vaccines are very much advanced. Okay, you need singles. There are some vaccines which claim only single shot can give immunity up to 3 years. Okay, so you have to consult your veterinarian for this one. Do not trust the medicine shops. Okay. Next, distemper and parvo adenovirus, they start at 6 weeks or 1.5 months, that means they start from 6 weeks or 1.5 month. Next, the non-core vaccines, the para-influenza 6 weeks or 1.5 months, Bordetella is 9 weeks, Lyme disease are 8 weeks or 2 months, Leptospira 8 weeks or 2 months, Corona starts from 6 weeks or 1.5 months, influenza 6 weeks or 1.5 months. Now we'll see how many doses you need. Okay, so for rabies it's single shot, whether puppy or adult, only one dose is sufficient enough. Next, for these four, the distemper, parvo and adeno, the puppies need 3 doses. Okay, the interval mostly is followed is 2 to 4 weeks between the vaccines, mostly. Okay, 2 to 4 weeks. Next, 3 doses. In case of adult, you need 2 doses of the vaccine. Here, the non-core, the para-influenza, 3 doses in puppy, adult is single dose, but it comes as a combined vaccine. Okay, so in adult, you can give 2 doses. Okay, the Bordetella, whether puppy or adult, 2 doses, one primary, then one is booster, then Lyme disease, same, Leptospira, same, in puppies, 2 doses, in adults, 2 doses, but this comes as a combination vaccine, multivalent vaccine. So you may give in puppies 3 doses. Next, Corona, the in case of puppies 3 doses, whereas in case of adult 2 doses. The influenza, puppy 2 doses, in adult 2 doses. Okay, remember the interval between the doses is 2 to 4 weeks. Okay, in like in days or so, 15 to 30 days. After this, I will give an example of some sample protocols. After that, we will go for Q&A. Okay, you may have some questions or frequently asked questions that we will cover in this video. Okay, no problem. So if you have some doubts till now, I hope in the Q&A session we will cover that. Next, some vaccines which are available. Okay, some brands provide DHPPI. You see, D4 is distemper. Okay, D for distemper, H for hepatitis, P for parvo, okay, PI for para influenza. Okay, some provide DHPPIL, they add Leptospira. Okay, some similarly, only parvoviral vaccines are also available. Only coronavirus vaccines are also available, and in some they combined the DHPPIL with C, that is Corona. Okay, next, rabies vaccine. You see, medicine shops and some medicine companies, they will tell 7-in-1 disease vaccine, 11-in-1 disease. There is nothing but the combination vaccines. What they will do? The Leptospira has 4 serovars. Okay, that means, you can, in common language, you can understand there are 4 different species of Leptospira. Among them, 2 are highly necessary, while the rest 2 are not that necessary, depending on the prevalence of disease. So what they will do, the medicine shop owners or medicine companies, they will add all the 4. You see, 4, this one is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, okay, and there will be different serovars of 10 Corona. Okay, so they will add different serovars only. Okay, they will tell 11-in-1 disease, 7-in-1 disease. So these are nothing but to fool you. Okay, so go to your vet, he or she will prescribe the vaccines which are beneficial for your pets. You see, there are some vaccine companies, you will find the worst type. They will be selling you in medicine. If you go for medicine shops, what they do, they will seek more for margin money. Okay, suppose a vaccine costs 300 rupees, they are selling at 600 rupees. The margin is 300 rupees. The profit margin is 300 rupees. But the vaccine is not good. Generally, the DHPPIL vaccine will cost around 600 rupees. Okay, but see, if it is a very good company and a bad company, very good company, the manufacturing cost is nearly about 500 rupees. The profit margin is 100 rupees, whereas for a bad company, the manufacturing cost is less than 300 rupees and selling cost is 600 rupees. Margin money is 300 rupees. The medicine shops will provide you this vaccine, the bad vaccine, because the margin of cost is 300 rupees, the profit is more, okay, but your pet won't be benefited, okay, or you won't be benefited. We will be, there are many incidents, especially the parvoviral infection, okay. If you are not giving good vaccines, good branded vaccines, what will do, the parvovirus infection, it is generally starts from January end or February 1st to up to February last or March. The, in this period, the parvovirus cases are more. If you are not given a branded vaccine, then your pet will suffer from vaccine failure. Okay, you will coming to the hospital for parvovirus infection. Mostly this infection is very severe in puppies specifically. So you need to consult your veterinarian. Okay, don't go to medicine shops for vaccination. Okay, next we will go for cats. Okay, some owners keep cats, specifically ladies. So first one is rabies. It is important in even in humans also. So rabies, you can start from 12 weeks. In some articles they suggest from 8 weeks or 2 months. Okay, in some articles you may find. Okay, rabies, then feline pan leukopenia virus. This one is feline herpes virus. This causes the rhinotracheitis in case of cats. Rhinotracheitis. This is feline calcivirus. These three will start from 6 weeks or 1.5 months. These two are non-core vaccines in case of cat. Feline leukemia virus, then Bordetella species. These two, I have not seen the availability of these two, but this one is available in many of these shops. Okay. So this vaccine has come as feline RCP vaccine. R for rhinotracheitis, C for calcivirus, P for pan leukopenia virus. Okay, feline RCP vaccine. Next, the rabies vaccine. The feline RCP vaccine is mostly given 3 doses at a dose interval of 2 to 4 weeks. Okay, that is 15 to 30 days interval. Okay, in case of adult cats, you can give 2 doses at 2 to 4 week interval. So this is basically the vaccines in case of dogs and cats. Now we will go for some sample protocols for dog and cats, but you can design your own protocol. Now we will understand some sample protocols. Before going for sample protocols, remember the vaccine starts from 6 week and ends in 16 week in puppies. Okay, so you have to finish your vaccination by 16 weeks. Okay, it will start from 6 weeks. Remember, it starts from 6 weeks but ends in 16 weeks. Okay, this is the time frame, 6 weeks to 16 week or 1.5 months to 4 months. And this is a sample protocol. Okay, you can give in these protocols are for puppies, this one for the adults. Okay, so you can start from DHPPIL, then corona, DHPPIL, rabies plus corona. I will discuss in question and answer whether you can combine the vaccines, whether you can combine multivalent vaccine with monovalent vaccine. Okay, I will discuss that in Q&A. So DSPPL, rabies plus corona, DSPPL, corona. You can see you have maintained a gap of 4 weeks between the vaccination. I told you the between the vaccination, between the doses of vaccination, you have to maintain 2 to 4 week. Okay, here you are maintaining 4 week. Okay, now this is another protocol. You can give DSPPL plus corona. Okay, next DSPPL plus corona, rabies. You see, fix the rabies vaccine. Okay, it should be given at 3 months. Rabies, then DSPPL, corona. You can see here between the doses, suppose DSPPL, you are maintaining the 4 week. Now here, this is another protocol. Suppose every pet owner at pet parent may not come at 6 week of age. Okay, suppose they have come at 8 weeks or the completion of 2 months. So what you have to do, you can design your protocol like this: first DSPPL, then corona, rabies plus DSPPL, corona, DSPPL plus corona. You see, between these two doses you are maintaining the 4 weeks, between these two weeks. Okay, it's not a problem. You have to maintain 2 weeks to 4 weeks. It is not a hard and fast rule that you have to maintain 4 weeks. You have maintained from early, you have maintained first 4 weeks, then you cannot reduce it to 2 weeks. It is not a hard and fast rule. You have to maintain between 2 to 4 weeks. Even you can maintain in 3 weeks also. Okay, this is a protocol for cat. Okay, you can start from RCP vaccine at 6 weeks of age. Okay, then next dose, here we are maintaining 2 weeks of interval. Okay, next rabies, FERCP, you can start from, suppose the cat or kitten came at 8 weeks of age or 2 months of age. So this one is not there, the FERCP, rabies, FERCP, then another dose of FERCP. So you have to design your own protocol on your, in your mind, or you can make a standard protocol and keep it under your table. When the pet parents will come to you, you can write the prescriptions. Okay, so this is basically, remember, 6 weeks and 16 weeks. It should start from 6 weeks, it should end in 16 weeks. Okay, so why 6 weeks, I will discuss in Q&A. Why 6 weeks? Next, this one is for adult. Remember, for smaller breeds, the adult age is 9 months, while as large breeds like Labrador or Doberman, the adult age is 15 months. Okay, so it's, you remember this, smaller the breed, they become adult little bit early. Next, you can buy this like day 0, 15, 30, 45 and 60. You can design, this is just a sample, okay. You may not follow this protocol, but you can design your own protocol and design it now, okay. So DSPPL, corona, DSPPL, corona, then rabies, or you can start from rabies, rabies, then DSPPL, corona, DSPPL, corona. This is a adult protocol for kittens. FERCP, then rabies, FERCP, or you can start from rabies, FERCP, FERCP. Okay, you can do that. Remember, suppose the you have given, suppose this started in 15th of month. Okay, suppose next 15th of month, if the animal comes 1 to 2 days delay. Okay, suppose he came on 17th, or even he came early as 14th. Okay, there is no problem. Okay, you do not need to change all the dates. Okay, so 1 to 2 days relaxation can be given in case of vaccinations. Okay, so this is all about the vaccination, the sample protocol. Remember, the booster doses, the annual boosters given the date from date of primary vaccination. You see, this is in this protocol. Suppose I have to give the annual booster of DSPPL. Okay, so I am not giving, I won't give the DSPPL booster on this date. Okay, I have to give the DSPPL booster on the primary vaccination. Okay, suppose this one is 15 April. Sorry. 30 April. This one is 15 May. This one 30 May. This is 15 July, May, June. This one is 30 June. Okay. So, after completing the vaccination protocol, I have to give the annual booster. So, for DHPL, the annual booster is 15 for, suppose this one is 15 for 20. So, the annual booster will be 15 for 21. Okay. It is not 15-6-21. Okay, the annual boosters are given from the date of primary vaccination. Okay. Suppose for corona, I won't give the corona annual booster on this date. I will give the corona annual booster in this date, the 34-2021. Okay, boosters are given from the date of primary vaccination. This is all about vaccination. Now I will go for Q&A. Okay, this is very important. Some common myths and some common concepts we can understand from Q&A. So coming to some commonly asked questions or common doubts in students,
First of all,
why 6 week, 8 week, or 12 week? Okay, first question. I told you for parvovirus or distemper virus or adenovirus, the age is 6 weeks, and for rabies, the primary vaccination age is 12 weeks. Why? Because of maternal antibody. Okay, so the puppies, when they are born, they have some antibody against the diseases. Okay, they receive it from their mother. Okay, so those antibodies will protect from disease up to, suppose for parvovirus, it will protect up to 6 weeks. After that, the level of antibody will decrease, so we have to give vaccine to boost up the immunity. Next, why booster is needed? We can understand from the graph actually. Suppose this is time, this one is antibody level. Okay. When they are born, okay, suppose I am discussing about vaccination against parvovirus. Okay. When they are born, they have some antibody level. There is a threshold level. You see, this is not actually the technical understanding. Okay, I am not using any technical terms. I am using to make you understand in a simple language. Okay, this is not actually the technical understanding. So for better understanding, you can refer any immunology book, but for a reference or for understanding, I am giving in a simpler term. Suppose this is the threshold level. If the antibody level is maintained at this level, then there is enough antibodies to bind into the antigen, that is the virus, so that disease won't occur. So when puppies are born, okay, they have this level, or maybe above this level. I am taking an example. They have this level. When they will grow up, this level will start to decline. So you have to give vaccine. Okay, so this is declining up to, suppose this is 6 weeks. Okay, next you have given a dose in 6 weeks. What will happen? The antibody level will rise. Okay, but it won't rise up to the level of threshold. So after some time, it may start declining. So before declining, at the 10 weeks, suppose this is 10 weeks, okay, you have to maintain 2 to 4 week interval. So you have given another booster. So what will happen? Instead of declining, it will again rise up. Suppose even after giving second booster, this may not reach the threshold. So at 14 week, suppose this is 14 week, you gave another booster. Okay, it will rise the antibody level above the threshold. So we have to maintain the antibody level above the threshold value. So that is why we need boosters of some vaccine, like the parvovirus vaccine, the leptospira vaccine, and distemper virus vaccine. So these vaccines, you need boosters. But in case of rabies, it may not need it. It is a single dose vaccine. By single dose, you can reach up to the threshold level. That is why this is single dose. Whereas some vaccines, specifically the multivalent vaccines, you have to give a 2 to 3 doses. So you understood why the booster needed. That is why for pet parents who are watching this video, do not miss the booster vaccinations. If suppose in 6 weeks the antibody will rise up, suppose you miss a dose at 10 weeks, okay, what will happen? This will come as declining. So when I will giving a booster at 14 week, it won't go up to this level. It will go up to this level, then it will decline. It may not reach the threshold value. So do not miss the booster vaccination doses. Most of the pet parents, they miss the booster dose. Okay, so don't miss the booster dose. If the doctor is writing, then he has done some study in 5 years. Okay, so please obey. Don't miss the booster doses. Next, can rabies vaccine be combined specifically with multivalent vaccine. I have discussed in protocols, in some protocols you have to give rabies plus DSPPL. See, there is an article in ResearchGate, okay, it was published in 2018. They have taken the rabies vaccine in combination with the DHPPIL, distemper, hepatitis, parvo, para influenza, and leptospira. Okay, so what they did, they took two groups. Okay, in case of dogs, they took two group A and group B. Okay, in case of group A, they gave only as single vaccines. Okay, like DSPPL single vaccine with boosters. Okay, so as a single vaccine means one at a time. Okay, DSPPL and rabies, whereas in group B, they gave combination vaccine, DSPPL, rabies. So after a year, when they analyzed the serum, okay, for antibody level, they found they have similar antibody levels. Okay, so it was concluded for rabies, the antibody level will, antibody for rabies do not have any problems with antibody for distemper, hepatitis, parvo. So for each disease, the antibody reaction or the development of antibody is different. Okay, they do not interfere in each other. So you can give the combined vaccine with the rabies vaccine or multivalent vaccine with rabies vaccine. There is absolutely no problem. Okay, next, what is post-bite vaccination? You might have heard, okay, in case of dogs, dog bite cases. So the post-bite vaccination, there is a schedule for post-bite vaccination. It is 0, day 0, 3, 7, 14 and 28. Okay, most of the articles refer 5 doses. Okay, you may find in some old book 6 doses, another one is 90 days. 0, 3, 7, 14 and 28. You see when to give 5 doses, when to give 3 doses. Okay, most of the time I will discuss when I will start wounds. Okay, so for category 1 wound, when there is only abrasions or some cell skin trauma, okay, it has not penetrated the whole thickness of skin. Okay, you can give 3 doses, 0, 3 and 7. But in case of when the skin is breached, you give 5 doses. Okay, so this is the post bite vaccination schedule. You see, if your dog is well vaccinated, you may not need vaccination, but dil hai ke manta nahi, so the owner might tell you to give vaccination, so remember this. So next, what will happen if animal misses a dose of post bite vaccine? So another one, remember, when the day 0 is counted, day 0 is counted when the animal is presented to your veterinary dispensary or hospital. Okay, if some animal is presented after 7 days, then that 7 day is day 0 for you. From that day, the vaccination will start. Okay, next, what will happen if the animal misses a dose? You see, for these 3 doses, these 3 are strict doses. Okay, in these 3 doses, you should not miss any date. Okay, suppose you have given this in 1st of May 105, this one will be in 405, the 7 day will be 805, the 14 will be on 1505, then this will be on 29th. Okay, these are dates. First, the 3 doses, that is on 1st of May, 4th of May and 8th of May, these 3 are strict doses. You should not differ by a day also. You have to give 3 doses on day. Suppose the animal has missed a dose, then you have to start vaccination from day 0 again. Okay, but in case of 14th and 28th day, for 14th day, a 2 days relaxation can be given. Okay, that means if the animal is not presented on 15th, it can be presented up to 17th of May. For 28th day, the relaxation is about 7 days.
Okay.
So we can present the animal up to 5th of June. But these three, they are strict doses. You should not miss these doses. If you miss a dose, then start from day zero. So this is all about some common questions asked or some common queries. So if you have any other doubt, you can comment below. I will try to answer your questions, or I may include in a separate video. So this is all about vaccination. So vaccine your pet, and remember, don't go to medicine shops or quacks for advice regarding vaccination. Consult a veterinarian. He or she will guide you properly. So if you like this video, please share with your veterinary buddies or friends, senior colleagues, or your pet owners. Thank you. Bye bye.